All right, so I'm doing a video here today that I've been contemplating doing for a while. Not really contemplating, I knew I was going to do it, but I just didn't feel it was the right time, and now I feel it's like the right time. And what kind of reminded me of this is the hitman's wife's bodyguard is coming out tomorrow, and the very first movie was The Last Day. When the last one came out, I actually saw that movie in theaters, and that was the last day where I felt what I would call normal. I'm going to be getting very personal here today and talking about something I've struggled with for the last 4 years. Well, actually about 3 years. I was finally able to eliminate both anxiety and panic attacks entirely about a year ago, and I'm going to explain how I did that. Now, before I get into this conversation, I want you to know I'm not a doctor. What I show you today is from my experience, but all the research that I did and what led me to do what I did, there's no question it helped, and I'm going to talk about what it's done for me since and what I've learned. This is going to be kind of a long video, so bear with me and go on this journey with me. And I would like to hear other people's comments on what they've gone through and what they've had to deal with. So 4 years ago, I felt completely normal, a normal person. I never had a panic. Well, I had a panic attack once, and I will bring that up when I get into this conversation a little bit deeper, but I'd never had a real panic attack before. I've had generalized anxiety in the past, but nothing too terrible. But I felt I was a normal person. You know, I felt completely normal, never had any issues, no heart issues, nothing at all. Well, 4 years ago, we were going on a camping trip. I think it was August of just about four years ago. And it was that night we were going to sleep. And I woke up at about 1:30 in the morning. I could hardly breathe. My heart was beating. It was beating fast. I could hardly breathe. And I woke up just out of the blue, and I felt this tingle go up my legs and into my body. And I got very warm. And then that's when the heart rate started to go really fast. And I freaked out. I couldn't think clearly. I could hardly talk. I had no saliva in my mouth. Something was seriously wrong. And I thought I was having a heart attack. Well, I'd only felt this way one other time before, and this is what kept me from like calling the paramedics or waking my wife up. She was sleeping in the bed next to me, and I almost woke her up, was the fact that I always relate things to movies, believe it or not, and if you've seen my channel, there are reasons for that. I see a lot of movies, and I can equate experiences to movies. And this was back when King Kong, Peter Jackson's King Kong came out. There was a big group of us that were going to King Kong. And I was working at Nabisco at that point, and it was during the holidays, and I knew that we were going to be going to that movie at night, probably around midnight, and it was a long day at work. It was always busy. That's our busiest time of year at Nabisco, was always during the holidays. And so I got some caffeine pills and decided to take one of those while I was working. Well, we also had a church function that night, and that's where the big group of guys came from. And usually at the church function, you know, it was our Christmas party. They would give us really good food, but we ended up having that year cold ham and some water. And I hadn't really had anything all day because of how busy I was at work. And so all I got was a little bit of ham and some cold water. Well, I decided to take another caffeine pill right before we went to King Kong, and this was a colossal mistake because about 5 to 10 minutes into the movie, I remember a really good friend of mine, Kyle, was sitting right next to me, and I started to freak out. I got this terrible feeling that something bad was going to happen, like someone in front of me was about to kill me, which is a completely irrational thought. I couldn't think straight, and I stood up, and I was very confused, and I was bothering the patrons around me, and that's my friend Kyle kind of, he grabbed me by the arm and he led me out of the theater, and we went to the lobby and we tried to get something to eat. I knew this was the problem. And we tried to get something to eat, but they'd already closed the concession stand because it was after midnight, even though the movie was going to be 3 hours long. And so I didn't get much of anything. I was able to get a drink. I had a drink, but that was it. But I kind of calmed down out there. I went back, and to this day, I still have not seen King Kong since because of the experience I had, but it was the scariest feeling I'd ever had, this impending feeling of doom, things going dark, not being very confused. Well, what happened to me that night was a very similar feeling, but it was ratcheted up by 10. Now, I figured it was because of the caffeine. And this is what had happened earlier that day when I went and saw the hitman's bodyguard. I didn't have much to eat that day. I didn't have breakfast. My dad was coming over to watch our house with our dogs, and we went to Barrow's Pizza, which is the best pizza in Arizona. And we went there to eat, and I had 2 slices of pepperoni pizza, and they had Bark's root beer at the time, which does have caffeine in it. And I filled that drink twice. And then we went to the movies, and I had popcorn and I had a cherry Coke, which is what I always used to do. Well, it was a lot of caffeine and it was just a bunch of carbs, not a whole lot of substantial food. So that night I kind of had a feeling this was kind of a repeat of what had happened when I went to the King Kong movie. So I struggled downstairs. Like, I could barely walk. Like, I had trouble just getting myself down my stairs into the kitchen. And I cooked up a couple of sausage patties to get some protein in my body. And I had no saliva. Like, I couldn't even chew anything. It was the strangest, scariest thing. But I was able to get them down after struggling. And I just had this really scared feeling. I was trembling. And I went upstairs. And this may be a little bit too much information, but I actually felt like I was going to have to go to the bathroom. So I sat on the toilet for about an hour, 45 minutes, somewhere in that, not an hour and 45, but 45 minutes to an hour, just waiting, and nothing really happened. And I felt like I was calm enough to where I could go back to sleep. So I go back to lay in bed, and I do fall back to sleep. But as soon as I fall asleep, it happens again. And I get this, all of a sudden, this rush goes up my body. And I felt scared as all get out. And I was like, something really bad is happening. So I decided to go into the bathroom again for a half an hour. And I tried to stay there. And the whole time my legs were like trembling, shaking. And I'm like, what the heck is going on? So I stayed in there for like another half an hour, 45 minutes. And I finally went back to bed. And then we got up probably 3 hours later to get up to go on our camping trip. I felt okay in the morning, but I felt a little off. And that's when we were driving out to our camping location up in northern Arizona. And on the way there, all of a sudden, that rush up my legs again. And I knew that feeling was coming on. And I told my wife, I got to stop. I've got to go get some food. So we pulled off into a McDonald's. I got food. And then I was good for the rest of the trip. And believe it or not, that whole weekend where we were camping, no issues whatsoever. I felt completely normal. But the day we got back, we went to this dollar store. And as soon as we went into the dollar store, I felt like I was going to puke. And that rush came up my legs again. And I got very scared. And I'm like, what is going on? Then a couple days later, I was just sitting in bed watching a Diamondbacks game. And the same thing happened again. And I'm like, all right, something is going on. This is not right. I need to go see my doctor. So I made an appointment to go see my doctor. First thing he did was he checked my heart. My heart was strong, good. Everything was good. He then did an examination and he said, he goes, you have high blood pressure. He said, I have a feeling that you have done damage to your body. You were active at Nabisco for 20 years and you go from that to sitting down, doing voiceovers and stuff like that all day long. And you've done damage to your body. You've squished your organs. You've got high blood pressure. We've got to get that under control. He goes, I'm going to prescribe you some medicine that can help with the anxiety if we need it. But first I want to get your blood pressure under control. So he gave me some blood pressure medicine, metoprolol. I don't know how you say it, but I was on the lowest dosage you could take because my blood pressure wasn't crazy bad. Well, I took that for a couple of weeks, but the panic attacks still continued after that. And you have to understand, I've never had panic attacks before, ever, ever. Other than that thing with King Kong, I had never had a panic attack. And so I was like, this isn't getting better. So I called the doctor and he prescribed me some medicine, some low-level medicine that he said would help. He gave me 2. One was going to get rid of the anxiety as, you know, within 15 minutes or 20 minutes of taking the pill. It was for real serious attacks. And then the other one was something he wanted me to start taking on a daily basis to get into my system. And I didn't want to take this because I'd taken some anxiety medicine like way back about 22 years ago. And I didn't like what it did to me. So I came off those medicines. Well, he put me on this medicine and I only took it for about 4 months because I started having very irrational thoughts, not of suicide. I've never been depressed. I've never had anything like that. But I'd had irrational thoughts. Like I'd be watching TV and I'd see somebody on the screen and I'd be like, they're a demon. And that I'm sitting there going, this is a completely irrational thought. And I knew it, but I felt like things were weird. And even my dreams, I got to the point where I couldn't make out dreams from reality. Like my dreams felt like real life. And I got off the medicine within 4 months. And I told my doctor, I said, I can't take this anymore. I will deal with the panic attacks. So then for the next several years, I was dealing with these off and on. Now, it was never as bad as when it first started, but the blood pressure was under control and I was still taking blood pressure medicine and trying to get used to that. But the panic attacks got debilitating to the point where I couldn't even function most of the time during the day. And it affected my ability to run my business. It affected, I also teach voiceovers and it affected me teaching my students. It got pretty bad. Well, I started doing some research on how to naturally get the panic attacks to go away. I watched some videos where they talked about just tell yourself everything's okay. You know it's okay because nothing ever bad actually ever happens. And I started doing that and it did help. And I was able to get it mostly under control, but not completely gone. And I just got to the point after a couple of years where I was like, am I ever going to feel normal again? I just want to feel normal. And so I did some more research online, and that's when a friend of ours talked about taking CBD oil. So we did. We got some CBD oil to give it a shot, and sure enough, it definitely helped. It almost got the panic attacks and the anxiety to completely go away, but it wasn't perfect. And in fact, every time we would go get more CBD oil, we would find that the concoction was never the same. It didn't react the same in our bodies each time we would take it. One batch would be better than another. Some may not be effective at all. So I got tired of doing that. My brother actually put me onto a CBD oil that was water-based that only took a few drops. And that stuff is amazing. We got a bottle of that for Christmas about a year and a half ago, and we still have some left because if you need it, it you only need to take a couple drops and it works like that. Whereas other CBD oil takes like a half an hour or so to kick in. But it still didn't entirely get it to go away. And then about a year ago, I started doing some research online because a year ago, about a year ago, was the most stressful time I'd ever had in my life. And I knew something was wrong internally, you know, with my body. Things were off. I had just gotten done painting my cabinets in my kitchen, which took like 2 weeks nonstop. I went into building an arcade cabinet and then building a pinball cabinet, which took up quite a bit of time. The pandemic hit. We were dealing with that. And then our car, our family car that we still had 3 years to pay on, had a massive issue with the engine that the dealership was going to total the car out. But my brother and I decided to go ahead and take care of it ourselves. So we tore the car apart over 5 to 6 weeks and repaired everything. And knock on wood, the car worked great, but it was extremely stressful. And then one of my daughters found out she had a couple of tumors. My 17-year-old did. And she had to have those removed. She found out on her birthday in July last year. And so she ended up having to go have surgery in October. So I knew I was extremely stressed out. Like I've never been that stressed out in my life. And so it culminated with me getting online doing research. And I came across, I felt like my testosterone was low. Like I knew it was low. I could tell. And I started reading that about cortisol. There are two chemicals in the body. There's cortisol and there's testosterone. And it's a teeter-totter. When one goes up, the other goes down. When the other goes up, the other goes down. So I knew my cortisol was extremely high. And I knew my testosterone had to be really low. So I did research on what could I do to get my testosterone up fast. And the two things that I found, one was doing exercise, lifting weights and stuff like that, which I have weights at home, which I did start doing. And then I found the miracle stuff that I started taking. And this is what this whole video is about. And I'm telling you right now, if you have anxiety, if you have panic attacks, this stuff is amazing. And I'm going to talk about what it did as soon as I started taking it. It's something called ashwagandha. Now, I'm not getting paid for this. My channel is not monetized as of yet, and I'm not getting paid to talk about ashwagandha. This is just for my own research, and I'm not a doctor. So you can always talk to your doctor before you take anything, but ashwagandha is 100% natural. It does not have chemicals in it. It is from a plant. It's kind of in the nightshade category. And I started taking this. Now, this is 2,100 milligrams, and I will tell you, this is pretty high. But you're supposed to take this 3 times a day. So I started taking this 3 times a day because this stuff will naturally lower your cortisol, which will naturally raise your testosterone. So I started taking this 3 times a day. On the second day that I was taking it, my wife was watching some of her friends' kids. And her kids were over here, and it was time to bring them home. And my wife was going to do it, but my 7-year-old daughter, the one who had the tumor, said, you know, I will take her home. Me and my boyfriend will take her home. Well, her boyfriend's car at the time did not have a gas gauge that worked properly. And on the way there, they ran out of gas. It was off in a safe area, off to the side of the road, just about 2 miles from where we live. But normally that would have strung me out. And I would have said, these stupid kids, you know, him and his stupid gauge, let's go get the gas. Let's go take care of it. But I didn't do that this time. It was really interesting. I was like, all right, let's go get the gas can. Let's go to the gas station. We'll fill it up. We'll go over there and we'll get them situated. Now, normally I would have just given them the gas can and let them deal with it and do it on their own. But I actually got out, helped her get the gas into the car the way that they needed to, because the way the nozzles work, it wasn't letting it go in. So I went over there and made sure that the gas got in, and we followed them to the gas station to get gas. And on the way there, on the way home, my wife looked at me and she said, what the hell's wrong with you? And I said, what do you mean? She goes, you are so calm. And I said, I don't know. It has to be that ashwagandha. And sure enough, that's what it was. Ashwagandha takes the edge off entirely. No anxiety, no panic attacks, zero, none whatsoever. And the anxiety level is extremely low. And I took this for a while and then came off of it because I got back to normal. And I've had my testosterone checked since. And my testosterone is still not all the way where it should be, but it's getting pretty close. And it's all because of this. And this got those panic attacks to go away. So this finally allowed me to get rid of the panic attacks and the anxiety entirely. It's gotten to the point now where I can't even take one a day. If I take one a day, like I took this for the last 3 days in a row, and I couldn't take one yesterday because I had no energy to do anything. It totally took the edge off. And I've been going to the gym a lot. And yesterday I couldn't. I just kind of laid around. Well, I did some stuff around the house, but I didn't do anything. I had no energy to do anything. And it's not that it makes you drowsy, like you can't operate large equipment or anything like that. But what it does is it calms your body down. You get very relaxed, but you don't lose any of your senses, which is incredible. This stuff helps your joints and a whole bunch of other things. So ashwagandha is that magical thing that allowed me to finally defeat the panic attacks and get back to normal. And now I've got a gym membership. I'm walking up to 10 miles a day. I'm doing everything I need to get my health where it needs to be. And I started this process about 2 months ago, and I'm off blood pressure medicine. My blood pressure is completely back to normal. And for the first time in 4 years, I feel completely normal again. And I could tell you it's because of this stuff here. I cannot praise this stuff enough. The ashwagandha has helped me out more than anything I could have possibly envisioned. And it's gotten me back to a normal person. And I can't tell you how good I feel and how this stuff changed my life from what it was just a year ago. So if you guys are having anxiety or you're having panic attacks and you've never heard of it, it is totally worth looking into. It's not some chemical that's going to change your brain makeup or anything like that, like some of these other medicines that these doctors want to prescribe to you. Because I'll tell you, all these medicines that these doctors want to prescribe to you, they kind of want you on them for life. The drug companies do. They don't want you coming off of them. And so that's why I decided to come off that medicine as quickly as I could and deal with it naturally. The CBD helped, but it wasn't perfect. But this stuff was way better. And I haven't had to take any CBD oil in over a year. This stuff is natural and it has worked tremendously well. And it's allowed me to focus again. And that's why I said 2 months ago, I want to start losing a little bit of weight. And I haven't gained a whole lot of weight. I think being a voice actor, I think I've gained 6 pounds since when I worked at Nabisco, but I've now lost about 20 pounds and I am lighter than I've been in the last 20 years. And all of this has helped me get back to being normal. So if you guys have used ashwagandha, I'd like to hear from you. I would like to hear about your experiences with anxiety. What have you guys learned along the way? I really hope this video can help people. I'm going to start kind of a health segment. And I'm not going to post a lot about health and things that I've learned, but this will be a product review kind of under health. And this will be the first of videos. I'll do some other ones coming up that have to do with some other things that I've started to do and things I've learned about eating healthy and eating the right way. I'll definitely post some stuff about that as well. But this is a product review on ashwagandha, and I give this 5 stars plus. This is one of the coolest things I have ever found. Now, a little tip about ashwagandha. This has black pepper extract in it. So if you're ever going to take ashwagandha, you got to make sure it has the black pepper extract, because if it doesn't have that in there, it is not going to, your body will not absorb the nutrients. So you want to make sure it absorbs it. I'm actually going to be going with a much lower milligrams so that I can take one a day without it knocking me so far down that I just don't have the energy to do anything. It doesn't affect my brain or my alertness, but it definitely calmed me down so much that I was just so relaxed that I just didn't have the energy to do anything. So I haven't taken it yesterday and I haven't taken it today, and I am going to the gym tomorrow morning. So I want to get back out there and get that, but this is going to be something I'm going to take, but in much smaller quantities. So ashwagandha, can't give it enough praises. Again, if you like the video, please hit the like button, subscribe, hit that notification bell, and you will be notified when I have new videos go up. And I do appreciate if you stuck around and watched the video, and let me know if it was helpful for you guys. Take care.